Hi, I'm Ola, and this is Gardening is for Girls. If we want to learn how to program, we should first answer the question, what is a programming language? So programming is about giving orders to the computer. But to be understood by a computer, we need to first use the language they understand. Second, we need to communicate very, very clearly because they are not as smart as people. Programming language is the format to tell your computer what you want. In a real world, you could ask your friend, "Could you buy me some sweets, please?" And they'll do that. You also can ask computers to do something for you, but people are smart and they already have a lot of knowledge. So your friend who is going to buy you some sweets knows what the sweets are, they know where to get them in a shop, they know that they need money to do that. If you would like to ask the computer about the very same thing, you need to tell the computer all these details. So things that we, humans, take for granted are not that easy for computers because we need to specify all single little detail. And things that seems to be very, very easy to do, it's not that easy if you try to implement it. We have a number of different languages and Python is one of them. So what you could do with Python? Basically anything that computers can. You could build a website, create a game, build scientific software, do graphics, and so on and so on. Sky is the limit here. Python is kind of old and it originated in late 80s when Guido van Rossum started implemented it. It is called after Monty Python Flying Circus series. A kind of confusing thing is that programmers talk about Python when speaking about two different things. One of them is a language itself, like English, German, Spanish, or Polish. It's a set of rules and words that creates a language itself, so it is the way you communicate. Other thing is a Python interpreter. You give orders using programming language, and then you need to translate the code. It's a real challenge, but we are lucky enough because many, many people before us did a lot of work, and now we don't really need to think about hardware that much. And we can use something more human-friendly, like writing Python programs. Today we're gonna install Python, the Python interpreter, to be able to code in Python language. If you have Mac or one of the distribution of Linux, there is a high chance that you already have Python installed. But probably you have one of the older versions. We are interested in the most recent version. I'm using Mac, so if you want to install Python on Windows or Linux, just check our demo course tutorial. I will put link below and follow all the instructions. So today, the most recent version of Python is Python 3. Okay, so we need to go to the address python.org downloads release Python 3 for brief. Now we will download Python installer. We are choosing 64-bit/32-bit installer file. Now double-click the file you downloaded to run the installer and complete installation. So all we need to do is check if it works. Let's open command line. And if you don't know what command line is, you should check my previous video about command lines. Now let's type python 3 space --- version. It will tell you what's the version of Python 3 we are using. So it's a success, we installed Python. But there is one thing that will be super useful for us, and this thing is a code editor. We want to make sure that we are having a good tool to write, edit, and save our programs. There are loads of different code editors. And in fact, many programmers are having battles about which code editor is better. Personally, I think whatever works for you and suits you best. But now, I will just show you how to install one of the available code editors out there. I decided to install Atom. Just go to atom.io, download it, and install it. You might be tempted to ask, why do you need a special code editor? Well, you write your programs in text, so why not to use Word or text editor? The thing is that you need to write your programs in something called plain text. Word or text editor produce something called rich text. So, apart from the text itself, they also know what's the format. For example, what the font was used, how big it was, and so forth. And we cannot have this information in our programs. We just need the text. Other thing that is incredibly useful when you write programs is code highlighting. So all programming languages have special structure, special keywords, and your code editor will highlight it for you. So it will be much easier to see what's going on in the program. It looks like that, and it's very, very nice feature. Now, we are finally ready to write our first Python program. In my next video, I will show you very basics of Python. Make sure to subscribe to this channel if you don't want to miss any episode, and stay tuned. Have a nice day and see you!